Pandemic time. 1. The dog goes out, the cat comes in. Daffodils so early, and a day later, sleet clinging to their surprised ruffles. The ceiling fan spins. Purple red buds dissolve the pre-vernal tangle of green into anticipation and rain. I can't remember in my safe bed what I dreamt or why my girlhood chest trembles in its 60-year-old skin. Tomorrow I will bend low to where Lily of the Valley finally matches time, which is not time as I knew or embellished, but its own flock of red-winged blackbirds flashing fire over the wetlands, where I arrive again every few days, weary of my own mind's compost pile, to wander at least 6 feet away from children not going to school, parents not going to work, and dogs not going to sleep on the couch, all of us casting our wishes on the power of water, the possibility of flight. 2. Around the world, pandemic time sings at the speed of urgency down one corridor to the ER or in a hut on the edge of a village, all weighted in the quiet bones of those who cannot gather around the dying, the dead, the grave that cannot yet be dug, in the place we never expected, for him, for her, for them. 3. The female cardinal, faded orange, all alarm, strikes her parade of notes, each tone dresses alike and looking for its mate somewhere in the field. A flame the size of a fingertip on the one candle, still burning at Shabbat service then. Oh, say shalom, oh, say shalom, shalom alechem v'yako Yisrael. Jack and Susan singing while three sing with them. One square out of 18 on Zoom, striking the match of our song somewhere in the forest. 4. It's 2:13 a.m. somewhere. Wait, that's here, or is it? Who cooks for you? Called the barred owl. Who cooks for you now? No one, I speak aloud. No one at all, answers the dark sheen and smudged starlight landing after thousands of years here on the window pane.